All right, well, let's also talk about the potential impact here. To talk about all of this, Rob Wilson, an independent financial advisor. So, Rob, people are worried about their 401ks. You can't help, you know, but expect that people will think kind of selfishly, how does this impact me? They get a little nervous or wondering if they need to start moving things around. What's your best advice to folks who are so nervous?
My absolute best advice for people who are a little bit nervous about what's going on right now is to not panic. Panic is never a good investment strategy. But for people who feel like this is the second coming of the financial crisis, look, this is not Lehman Brothers 2.0. We're not going to have another financial crisis because of this. Look, back then, I had to talk to my clients about whether their bank was going to be open the next day. This is dramatically different. It's going to take a few years for all of this to play itself out. So it's not the same risk as the financial crisis in 08.
Okay, and then there are interest rates. We've heard a lot about the discussions about right now interest rates are low, mortgage rates, you know, are historically at a low. Would news like this Brexit, in any way influence whether Janet Yellen decides it's time to raise interest rates?
Oh, of course. I absolutely think that the Fed will not want to raise rates amidst all of this turmoil. So if you're a consumer and you were thinking about borrowing money, this is really, really good for you. If you're in the market for a mortgage or if you were thinking about refinancing the mortgage that you already have, these interest rates are probably going to stay at historic lows. So this is actually a good thing for you. And because there's a flight to quality, the dollar is going to be strong, which could hurt our exports. But again, if you're a U.S. consumer, you're going to be traveling around the world, that vacation is going to get a little bit cheaper because the dollar is going to get stronger because of this. So if you're a consumer, there is some bright side to this.
All right. And just a reminder to folks, you know, Rob, that, you know, Europe is our biggest trading partner. Britain is a big part of that. So, of course, people think about jobs, the stability of their jobs, potential losses. What do you see?
You absolutely, if you're in a company that has very high exposure to the UK or Europe, or if you're in a company that does a lot of exports because of that strong dollar, there could be some headwinds that are going to affect your job. So you absolutely want to go talk to your manager, see how safe your job is, and at least have a plan in place if your company decides to reduce force. We did see a lot of that during the financial crisis. And you know what, Fred? This reminds me a lot of the debt ceiling debate in 2011 when the Dow dropped 3%. But look, a lot of times we gained back all of those points just in 3 months or less. Mm-hmm. So while past history doesn't guarantee future performance, all of this suggests that there's going to be a rocky time for a few months, but we'll probably get back to normal in 3 to 6 months.
All right. That's very hopeful. We like it. Rob Wilson, good to see you. Thank you so much.
Thanks for having me.
Okay.